Thank you for joining this video about a new research paper titled Fast Inference of Mixture of Experts Language Models with Offloading. In recent years, large language models are in charge of remarkable advances in AI, with models such as GPT-3 and 4, which are closed source, and with open source models such as Llama 1 and 2, and more. However, as we move forward, these models are getting larger and larger, and it becomes important to find ways to improve the efficiency of running large language models. One development that has been adopted with impressive success is called mixture of experts, often referred as MoE, where the idea is the different parts of the model, which are the experts, learn to handle certain types of inputs, and the model learns when to use each expert. For a given input, a small portion of all experts is used, which makes this model more compute efficient. One of the best open source models out there these days is the MoE model by Mistral, which is called Mixtral 8x7b. However, while being compute efficient, the MoE model's architecture has large memory footprint, since we need to load all of the experts into memory. In this paper, the researchers introduce a method to efficiently run MoE models with limited available memory, which even allow running Mixtral 8x7b on the free tier of Google Colab, which makes it much more accessible to researchers without a substantial amount of resources. In this video, we'll provide a short explanation about what are MoE models and explain the method presented in the paper. Let's start with a quick recap for how the mixture of experts method works. The common methods up until now are called sparse mixture of experts, and we also have a video about soft mixture of experts which you can find in the description of this video. The idea with mixture of experts is that instead of having one large model that handles all of the input space, we divide the problem such that different inputs are handled by different segments of the model. These different model segments are called experts. What does it mean? In high level, we have a router component and an expert component, where the experts component is comprised of multiple distinct experts, each with its own weights, and given input tokens such as the 8 tokens here, each token passes via the router, and the router decides which expert should handle this token, and routes the token to be processed by that expert. More commonly, the router chooses more than one expert for each token, so in this example we choose 2 experts out of 4. And then the chosen experts yield outputs which we combine together. These experts can be smaller than if we would use one large model to process all tokens, and they can run in parallel, so this is why the computational cost is reduced. The flow is repeated for each input token, so the second token also passes via the router, and the router can choose different experts to activate. For example, here it chose the top expert, same as before, and the third expert instead of the last, and it goes on for each input token. For the input prompt, the tokens are handled together, and we do not do this one after the other as shown in this example. However, for the generated tokens in the response, we have to go through this process token by token. This is an important distinction for the method we will explain in a minute. For the router, there are various techniques to implement the routing logics, which we won't dive into here. In this example, we also present a single layer, while there are usually more than one, so the outputs of this layer are moved to the next layer in the model. Before moving on, please consider to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. We also send 1-minute read summaries for the papers we review here by mail. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. Let's now add more layers to the model and discuss how offloading can help to improve the inference efficiency when there is limited memory. In the following drawing, for example, we have 3 layers. Each layer has a router and 4 experts, and each layer has its own weights. Note that this drawing is simplified in order to explain the offloading part. In a limited memory hardware, we cannot load the entire model into GPU memory. The expert's weights are in charge for the majority of the model size. We can keep the other parts of the model constant in the GPU, such as the routers and self-attention blocks, which are excluded from this drawing. And we're now going to see how the expert weights can be loaded efficiently. The generative inference consists of 2 phases. The first phase is input prompt encoding. Here, simple offloading technique already works quite well. What does it mean? When we process the input prompt, we first load the experts of layer 1 into memory. We color them with yellow to represent they are loaded into the GPU memory. Then we feed the entire sequence to the first layer, which handles all tokens in parallel. Once finished, layer 1 experts can be unloaded and make room for the experts of the second layer. Similarly, when layer 2 is done processing, the experts of layer 2 can be unloaded to make room for the experts of layer 3. In read models in the wild, we have more than 3 layers, and this process could continue. If the GPU memory can all the experts of two layers simultaneously, then there is room for even more optimization, since we could load the next layer expert during the processing of its preceding layer. But anyway, each layer experts are loaded only once, since we process the input sequence in parallel and layer by layer. In the second phase of the generative inference process, it gets more interesting. The second phase is tokens generation. The tokens generation phase is not only done layer by layer. Rather, in this case, we also generate the tokens token by token and layer by layer. So acting the same results in loading and unloading all experts for each generated token. So here, the researchers suggest to include the LRU cache. How does it work? When generating the first token, we start with the first layer. Say for example that the activated experts are the first and the third experts, so only these experts are loaded, and are kept in memory for now. Then, similarly, for layer 2, we load the activated experts only. For example here, these are the first and last experts. An important point to understand here is that if we only want to load the activated experts, we have to wait for the results of the first layer, since choosing the activated expert by the router is based on the previous layer output. Once we have the output of the second layer, we do the same in the last layer. Here, for example, the activated experts are the middle ones. Now, when we start the process to generate the second token, we already have two experts loaded in the first layer. Say for example that the activated experts in the first layer for the second token are the top two. Then we only need to load the second expert, so we save time here. Similarly, if in the second layer the activated experts are now the last two, then we only need to load the third expert. And in the last layer, let's assume for example that the activated experts are the same. In this case, there is no need to load any expert. In this example, the LRU cache size is 2 for all layers. The researchers have found that the LRU cache hit rate is large, meaning there are many cases where the activated expert is already loaded when we need it, so it improves the efficiency of the inference process. In the following figure from the paper, we can see an example for the LRU cache in action. We see here the experts of layer 0, where each row represents a different expert in that layer. The columns, as we can see at the bottom, represent a sequence of tokens. The blue cells, such as the expert 3 and 4 in the first column, represent that these experts were active while encoding the token, where deeper blue means that the router provided a higher value for that expert. The small gray squares represent the experts that are saved in the LRU cache. And as we move to the next token, we see that the experts we have in the LRU cache are experts 3 and 4, since they were the ones which were activated for the previous token. In this case, one of them, expert 4, is used also for the second token, while we need to replace expert number 3. Looking at the rest of the tokens, we can see there are many cache hits, where we reuse an already loaded expert. But we can also see there are quite a lot of cache misses, where we still need to wait and load an expert that is not in the cache. So, while LRU caching helps, the researchers have found another method to accelerate the model. The second method is called speculative expert loading. To explain this method, let's review an example for how it will work when we proceed to generate the third token. In the first two layers, there is no change from before, and we still use the LRU cache as we did. For simplicity, let's assume in this case there was no change in the loaded experts. With the third layer, we reach the interesting part. We already have two experts loaded in the LRU cache. However, another step that is added is that while we add the results from the first layer, we can try to guess, based on them, which experts will be used in the third layer, rather than waiting for the results from layer 2. We do that without introducing any new component, but rather by feeding the results from layer 1 to the router of layer 3. Then, if the guess is that the activated experts will be the first two experts, then we do the change in the loaded experts, in this case loading the first expert. And we do that in parallel while layer 2 is still running. When we have the results of layer 2, we still pass them via the router, and if the guess was wrong, then we fix and load the real activated experts. In order to understand the benefits of this, let's review the following figure from the paper, evaluated using Mistral 8x7b on the Open Assistant dataset. On the left we can see the hit rate for the LRU cache. And for example, when the cache is of size 2, the orange line, we can see that we have the correct experts in the cache in about 40% of the times. And if we increase the cache size to 4, if the hardware we use has enough memory for this, then the hit rate jumps to approximately 60% or more. On the right chart we can see the improvement when using speculative loading. In the regular lines that are not dashed, We can see in blue that if we prefetch based on speculative loading guess the experts of one layer ahead, then we have the correct expert loaded for about 80% of the times or a bit more, and with fetching 3 experts it improves to over 90%. The dashed and dotted lines shows the results when looking more than one layer ahead, which shows that the prediction of which experts are active is less accurate as we look farther ahead. Let's move on to talk about mixed MoE quantization. The researchers have tried to find a setting for the model that will be the most beneficial trade-off between model size and performance for offloading. In the following table from the paper, we can see the researchers have tried 4 different quantization methods for the attention layers and for the experts, and evaluated them using the perplexity of Wiki2 and C4 and MMLU accuracy. In green, we can see 2 chosen settings, both with 4-bit quantization for the attention layers, and one with 3-bit and the other with 2-bit quantization for the expert. We can see that in the chosen settings, the model size is relatively smaller comparing to other versions, but still provides relatively good results. Finally, we can see the inference speed when using the offloading method described in the paper. In the following table, we can see the result on low-tier GPUs for the 2 chosen model settings, where each value represents the number of tokens generated per second. When using the full algorithm, we can see that with 2-bit experts, we reach inference speed between 2 to 3 tokens per second. We can see in the bottom row the results for using naive offloading, where we just load the entire layer experts when needed, which is significantly slower. Specifically for Google Colab, we see the inference speed is 2 tokens per second with the paper method, comparing to 0.6 without it. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.